John Robert Toll. I can't believe we're standing here right now reading our vows to each other. It feels like yesterday when I met you for the first time. Throughout that whole day, I knew you were special and I wanted to continue to spend time with you. After our first official date at Lockside, I knew you were the one. I think God knew I needed you. Thank you for always loving me and being my biggest fan. Thank you for always pushing me to be my best self and encouraging me to try new things, even if it seems scary. And thank you for being patient with me when it comes to anything technology. You're the most loving, generous, patient, and kind person I know, and I'm so thankful to call you my best friend and now my almost husband.
Lane, the day we've been waiting for is finally here. Soon after we met, I knew that we would be standing right here today, promising you the rest of our lives. As we have said many times, everything happens for a reason, and I'm so happy that you are my reason. I know that fate brought us together, and I'm so lucky to have you as my wife and lifelong partner. You are beautiful, thoughtful, kind, smart, funny, hardworking, and so much more. I promise to love you unconditionally, selflessly, and endlessly. I will lift you up when you are down. I'll care for you when you are sick, and encourage you when you are overwhelmed. I will support your goals and celebrate your successes. I will protect and provide for you and our future family. I will be loyal to you and prioritize you always. I'll love you forever.
Truest desire on this day and at this time to choose Lane as your wife, to live together with her in marriage?
Yes, sir.
And do you swear today before God, myself, and all of our gathered family and friends to love, to comfort, to honor, to keep, to protect, to provide for her for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, remaining faithful to her only as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Lane, is it your truest desire at this time, on this day, to choose John as your husband, to live together with him in marriage?
Yes.
And do you swear today before God, myself, and all of our gathered family and friends to love, to comfort, to honor, to keep, to protect and to provide for him for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, remaining faithful to him only as long as you both shall live?
I do.
May these rings forevermore be the most treasured adornment that you ever wear, but may all that they symbolize be the most treasured possession that you ever own. John, taking Lane's ring, placing on the ring finger of her left hand, and as you do so, repeating after me, with this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I pledge to you today.
I pledge to you today.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
My life.
My life.
My love.
My love.
And my sacred honor.
And my sacred honor.
Lane taking John's ring, placing on the ring finger of his left hand, and as you do so, repeating after me, with this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed. I pledge to you today.
I pledge to you today.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
My life.
My life.
My love.
My love.
And my sacred honor.
And my sacred honor.
How you love the things I hate about myself that no one knows, but with you I see hope again. Oh, I'm a mess when I overthink the little things in my head. You seem to always help me catch my breath, but then I lose it again. When I get you, that's the end. And why do I get so nervous when I look into your eyes? Butterflies can't stop me falling for you. And darling, this is more than anything I felt before. You're everything that I want, but I didn't think I'd find someone who is worth the wait of all the years of my heartbreak. But I know now I've found the one I love.
I can still remember the first time I saw those brown eyes staring into mine. It was in that moment I felt a love I never knew I would find. It's like I took my heart right out of my chest and wrapped it all up in a little pink dress. Painted the most beautiful smile in the world, topped it all off with brown hair and curls. The day he made my baby girl. 'Cause the best parts of me are given to you, and I hope that all your dreams come true. And it's time baby.
Thank you for joining us, even though the weather did not want to cooperate. I think we made it. Yes? All right, so I have the privilege of giving the first speech tonight. I always assumed I'd be last, because traditionally you save the best for last, right? Good, you laughed. I won't cry. We'll see. Because I did. Yeah, at the first look tonight, I definitely cried like a baby. And then my daughter handed me a picture of us. It said, "My little girl forever." Yeah, that hurt. Okay, I gotta stay on script. And I have a time limit. Sorry. All right, so my wife and I want to thank everybody for joining us to celebrate this special occasion. Many of you have traveled long distances. We've got multiple states and countries. Joe, Okinawa, Japan, here we come. There's several family members that can't be here tonight. And we just want to take a minute to acknowledge that. However, I'm confident that they're watching over us tonight from above, and they're celebrating with us. Here we go. Lane. Or Wayne. As she used to introduce herself to every person that she met, it was Wayne. Whether we were walking around our first apartment, we were in a grocery cart, Lane met somebody, no longer a stranger, it was her friend. "Hi, I'm Wayne." That person would look at us with a confused look, and her mother and I would recognize that, and it was one of those, like, her name's Lane. Lane. And they're like, "Oh, okay, great." So Lane was never without her favorite comfort toy, which was Pink Puppy. And Pam, this is for you. If you were really special, Lane would offer Pink Puppy's tail. She would say, "Want some tail?" And offer you the most disgusting formula cereal bar crumb covered tail. And if she did this, it was an honor. You did not decline the tail. So Lane always sought comfort from Pink Puppy. So to calm my nerves today, and yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is the real pink gray puppy. So disclaimer, minus the tail. The tail was amputated by the CDC because we had a pandemic that was getting ready to occur. Okay. All right, Lane was a child of routine. Mornings consisted of a huge glass of milk, a cereal bar, a few episodes of Bear in a Big Blue House, while sitting in her Winnie the Pooh chair, and she would dress herself, always in a party dress. Every dress was a party dress. It didn't matter. It was a party dress. Lane, you found the ultimate party dress. You're beautiful. You're stunning. You took my breath away. John, you're a lucky man. Don't screw it up. Lane was a happy, joyful, fearless child. She's always applied herself 110% to whatever she set her mind to. Lane knew early on that she would follow in her late Meemaw's footsteps and become a teacher. She applied to one of the best teaching programs in Virginia and was granted early acceptance. Really haven't followed it. And then went on to complete her master's degree in 5 years. Her mother and I couldn't be more proud. Then Lane met John, a coastie, and brought him home. I don't hold the coastie part against you anymore, because not everyone can be a Marine, the few, the proud, the brave. Marines, yes. Derry and I were immediately impressed with John's character and personality and seemed immediately at ease around us. Their affection for each other was apparent from the very first time that we saw them together. John quickly felt like family, and today we make it official. Because John, you're part of the family. Now I have a lot more to say about John, but running out of time. I'm on time, Mac. I'm already over time, aren't I? All right, Joe, you got the rest. So in closing, I'm supposed to offer you two marriage advice. I'll make it simple. Always love each other. Recreate the feeling you're feeling right now as many times as you can. There's going to be tough times. You'll work through them. Just remember to love each other in words and actions and never stop.
So John has been dreading this speech because growing up, he was very terrible to me. And I don't know if this is his penance or trying to make up for that, but I will share a few childhood traumas. Kind of show you the person he was as a child, and you can see how well he's been fooling you guys with his good guy appearance. So like I said, growing up, he was pretty mean. We weren't very close at all. He was my arch nemesis. And he didn't do it by himself, though. There's a brother between us, and John didn't have the muscle by himself, so he enlisted my other brother to help him. But he was the mastermind, and my other brother was the muscle, and together they made my childhood very terrible. So a couple examples. One of the family favorites is, there's a lot of us in the family, in case you guys didn't notice. There's 15 of us kids. So the three of us were all very close in age. So at bath time, to save time, water, everything, the three of us usually had to bathe together. And so John and Mike, the brother between us, would stand up on the side of the bathtub and they would tell me to walk onto the bridge. And as I did, they would pee all over me. Yes, so that's, like I said, that's one of the family favorites. He still has never apologized for that, by the way. He just laughs, so. another one is, he's also a big reason why I was terrified of electricity for most of my life. We had a St. Bernard, and we had a dog collar, an electric collar. And the two of them chased me down, pinned me down, and with the collar on the highest setting, burnt two holes in my arm and held it there. And yeah, since that day, I was not very good friends with electricity. So there's many other examples I could give you. But with those two, I feel like y'all kind of get an idea of just a little bit of the trauma I experienced. As we got bigger, well, as I got bigger, he didn't grow much, but the torture stopped a little bit, and we started, you know, getting along a little more, came pretty close. And then within the last 3 or 4 years, we really gotten close. I actually moved to Virginia here and lived with him for about a year and a half before I moved to Japan. And during that time, we spent a lot of time together. Like I said, we grew really close. And I can say he's matured and grown into a more tolerable small man. So I'm not holding our childhood against him. It makes some good stories. When we met Lane, the first time she met all of us, or most of us, she heard all these stories and she stuck around. She laughed until she was crying. She didn't believe it. She's like, there's no way John would ever do that. But he said, oh yeah, he did. So Lane, when I moved to Virginia, I was the first in the family to meet her. And I was going through a rough time in my life when I moved here. And Lane and her family, they took me in, accepted me, and treated me as one of their own. And I'll be forever grateful and thankful for y'all for that. Lane, you're awesome. Your family is amazing. And I want to be the first to publicly say, welcome to our family, and I'm sorry for the family downgrade. It's, if you were smart, you would have stuck with yours. But I wish you both the best and all the happiness in the world.
Lane and I met at the very beginning of our freshman year, and we instantly clicked. We were lucky enough to have all the same classes together, and luckily we lived in the same hall. I'll never forget us sprinting back from our Thursday night classes so that we could pregame and get ready to go to frat parties. That was definitely the highlight of our freshman year. Who knew that freshman year was only the beginning of a lifetime of memories? I'm so grateful for our friendship and to have you to lean on when I make the absolute worst decisions. I can always count on you to tell me I was dumb and then to laugh with me through it all. Lane, there are endless memories from our drunken shambles freshman year to becoming sorority sisters and then being roomies at the High Street House. I can't wait to see where friendship goes. You're so driven and have such a strong commitment to your friends and family. Since graduating, I've seen you more than friends from home, and that speaks volumes. You're always so willing to take a weekend trip, even if it means driving long hours. Even though we're long distance besties, you're always a phone call away, and I know your door is always open, as is mine. John, thank you for always accepting me and keeping girls' night secrets to yourself. I know where to find you if you spill the tea. Thanks for being my pretend boyfriend when we're in crowded cities like Nashville. Most of all, thank you for loving Lane with all your heart. I know I can trust you to keep her and her heart safe. Lane and John, I couldn't be more happy for the two of you. I still remember Lane telling me she was going on a blind date, and now y'all are married. I'm so happy of your love for each other and can only hope to have the special bond that y'all share one day. And to end, I want to leave y'all with some advice, even though I'm the last person to give any marriage advice. But always try to compromise. Communicate the good, the bad, and the ugly. Respect each other. Don't give up on each other. Don't go to bed angry ever. And John, remember that Lane is always right. Happy wife, happy life. I can't wait to see what the future holds for y'all. Now let's raise our glasses and cheers to Lane and John.
Here we come, here we go. We gotta rock, 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 rock. Easy come, easy go. Now we on top. Feel the shot, body rock. Rockin' don't stop. Gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna